Hey guys, and welcome to another one, and welcome to the second part of our mini series on our Villa Intercom kit. Okay, so right now we're really just getting started, and we're going to be downloading the software we're going to be using to set up everything, and it's called IVMS 4200. Okay, so to download it, you just Google IVMS 4200. I'll leave a link below as well, guys, and I'm also going to leave some other links below for some, you know, a bit more. They're better guides, because I'm just going to show you where to go, but it's really easy. Okay, IVMS is nothing complicated about it. You don't even need an online account or anything. You will need to make just give them your name, but it's a local account. Okay, so even if you deleted IVMS and started again, then you could just do that and just, you know, create an account, just keep going. It's not like an online account where if you forget your password and all this stuff you have to go through hoops. No, it's just a local account on your PC, so it's really straightforward. So all you have to do, guys, is click on this one. You don't need the AC version, that's the access control version, I believe. Oops, I just accidentally downloaded it. Now you want to go ahead and download this version. It's quite big, 300 megabytes, so I'm not going to sit here and watch it download and install it, but just install it like any other program. Just click on select everything, go next, and then once you're inside the program, I'm going to see you there when I've loaded mine up. All right, guys. Okay, so hopefully you guys are into IVMS now and no problems. It's pretty straightforward, guys, really easy to install, and now we can go ahead and configure our devices. Okay, so providing everything is all connected on the same network, so make sure your PoE switch is connected to the router, and obviously your PC should be connected to that router somehow to give you the internet, and then everything should be able to communicate with each other, and we should be able to find the devices and set them up and go online and have no problems. Okay, so there's nothing, no special settings for a network, just make sure it's everything is physically linked somehow together and you should be all right. Okay, so let's go ahead and set them up now. So for this, we go to device management here on the right, and it will find all our devices on the network. Okay, I know we've got a few here, guys, it's a bit confusing, but you see these two here, these are inactive, okay, in red. That means they're essentially brand new and they're ready to be given a password and activated. Okay, so our top one is our door station. Okay, so let's go ahead and activate this right now. So I'm going to be using one password for everything in this setup, guys, and I recommend you come up with one password and stick with one password as well for yourself, and you shouldn't have a problem. And really try not to forget passwords, as they can be a bit of a pain to, you know, to get back. Oh, passwords did not match. Okay. So now the device becomes active and it's been given a password. So next time you want to be able to communicate with that device, it's going to be asking you for that password. Okay. But to communicate with the device, we have to do one more thing. We have to enable DHCP, or you can give it a static IP address if you know what you're doing there, but for now we're gonna just be enabling DHCP. But I do recommend you guys find out more about static IP addresses and things like that, and then we enter the password that we just created. Okay, so as you see now, enabling DHCP is going to give it an IP address from your router. Okay, so we got our device here, it still says the old IP address, but if we refresh, it's going to change it. Okay, and now we've lost the device, but I know it's here somewhere. Here we go, and it's given it an IP address of 10.4.4.30. okay, so we go add that, and we can call this door station. Username is always admin, and then the password we just created, and we go add. Okay, and you see online, that means you've done everything correctly. Okay, it's found the device and it's got IP address, you're all ready to go. Now we just go do the same thing on the screen, guys. So we're going to go activate, and we go same password, and we go okay. Okay, sometimes this happens, it'll throw up an error, but it does work okay. It will go active. Okay, device active. And now we do the same again. We click on the network icon, the modify Neutrino, and we go DHCP. And it should give it an IP address as well. Okay, so let's give this a refresh. So remember, guys, never add the device until you refreshed it and seen the new IP address, or add the old IP address. And here's our screen, and it's got 31, which usually happens. It usually give you an IP address after the last one it gave you. Okay, so we go ahead and add that, and we call this main screen. And put in the password. Go add. As you see, it's gone online as well. That means everything's been added correctly, and we're all good to go ahead and configure the main door station and main screen. Let's click on this cog icon and we'll bring up the configuration panel. Okay, you've got all our settings here. Perfect, guys, ready to go. Now, one thing we're going to do right now is going to update the firmware. Okay, so as you see here under maintenance, we have upgrade, and we can upgrade using a file. But the files can be tricky to get, so I'm going to go now to our website and show you where to download the files from, so we can go ahead and upgrade our intercom system to the latest firmware. Catch you in a sec. Alright, so I'm on our website, SSR Trading, and I will leave a link in the description. It's also our trade website. If you're interested in opening an account, go ahead and apply if you are in the trade or electrician or something like that. But right now we're going to go download the firmware. And I made some easy links, guys. Let's go technical support. Then we've got the latest firmware links, and then we've got intercom firmware. Okay. So as you see here, we've got some different ones here. So as you see here, we've got Villa door stations. So this is the one we need for the door station, and we've got the indoor station monitor. Okay, the model numbers there. We click on this. It takes you right to the page of that you need for the firmware. Okay, so you want to look at the dates and download the latest one. So the latest one will be obviously the latest date, which is this one. So we click on here, and it's got a couple of different versions here. Okay, as you see here, one's EU and one standard. We want this one, which it says STD here. Okay, so we're going to go download this one, because there is a Euro version of the screen, guys. I recommend do not go for the Euro version. I have heard of a few problems, and it comes in a zip file. Okay, guys, so you have to unzip that. It's pretty straightforward how to unzip a file. I hope you can do that. And then the file will be called DigiCap. Okay, no, is it? Yeah. All right, now we're going to download the firmware for our Villa door station. Okay, so check your model out. You might have the B version, you might not have the B version. It's easy to see the B version. It's the last letter of your Villa station, okay? And we're going to click on the B version and go by the latest date, which is usually the bottom one. Click here, and we've got two versions again. We've got the EU and we've got the standard, so we're going to go ahead and download the standard version. Okay, so go ahead and unzip those files, guys, get them ready, and then we're going to go back to IVMS and upload them to our door station and screen. Catch you there. Right, so I've installed the plugin. Let's go see if it's worked. So let's go to our door station. So this is why it's very important, guys, to keep everything up to date. And we go upgrade, we click on here, upgrade. Okay, yep, now you see it's popped up a window. Great. Then we go to our download folder, and as you see here, these are all the files we've been downloading. We've got IVMS, we've got the plugin, we've got the two zip files for the firmware, and now we've got our indoor and we've got our Villa. So obviously the Villa is the station, so we click on here and we can go to this DigiCap file. Okay, and go open. Now I would go upgrade, guys, but I already done it, unfortunately. We've got limited resources here. I can only upgrade one thing once and then I can't do it again. So, but I know it's going to work. Hopefully you guys just go ahead and update it, because it's always best to have the latest version of everything, and then you'll be able to follow my guide and with exactly the same firmware. So let me show you guys the latest firmware, and I believe it is under locals, I think. No, somewhere is the firmware I'm using. So bear with me. As you see, yeah, here we go, guys. So firmware is version 2.253 220180. Okay, So make sure that's the same. And let's go to our screen and I'll show you where to go for this. So we go to device information and the version is 2.134.211118. So this is the one I've used in the videos. And to upgrade the firmware here, it's the same process. We go here, select the file from the download folder, wherever you put it, indoor station, DigiCap, upgrade, and then you'll see it will go ahead and upgrade the file. So upgrading firmware, guys, a little bit of a minefield, so do be careful. But obviously, like I said, the batch configuration tool is a great backup, but always make sure everything's up to date. And especially for intercom, I know you guys maybe done CCTV and said, no, I don't want to upgrade the firmware. It is fair enough. CCTV is a lot more simple, but this, and especially when you go to more complicated setups, it's essential that you upgrade the firmware. Okay. So on the next video, we'll be doing our first setup, guys. So stay tuned for that and hopefully catch you there. Cheers. Bye bye.